This video takes a closer look at the software control panel of the Orion Studio. Let's first take a look at its basic functions. On the top of the software control panel, there's a monitor select and monitor volume control. From there, you can select which pair of monitors to currently use for listening, alongside a volume level and a mute button. In the center, there's the clock source menu from where you can select the clock source for the Orion Studio. The sample rate can be selected from the drop-down menu when in oven mode, or otherwise it will display the sample rate of the external source to which it's locked. The lock light indicates whether the Orion Studio is locked to a source, for example USB playback. Below this we have the channel gain selection. Here we have three options so we can view the preamp, ADAT and S Pdif inputs, and their gain trim control for each group of them. The preamp ins have interchangeable input types between line and mic, plus high Z for the first four inputs. Phantom power and phase reverse are available in every channel, plus stereo link, which pairs two channels together. The ADAT and S Pdif tabs have only the stereo link option available. Next, there are two separate headphone controls for headphone 1 and 2, with faders for the level controls, and two individual mute buttons alongside the talkback button and level controls. Below the display channels, we have the main screen for the Orion Studio. This can either display the routing matrix, the mixers, the effects, or the meters. If we select routing, the routing matrix will appear. Here you can make all routing possibilities by clicking and dragging from the from to the to section. The from section includes the following connections. The preamp inputs represent the 12 physical preamp ins of the Orion Studio. Thunderbolt TB play outputs and the USB play outputs are the outputs from your DAW, and therefore from your computer. So if you routed a stereo track from your DAW to outputs 1 and 2, for example, this means that this track will be outputted from USB play or Thunderbolt play channels 1 and 2, depending on whether you're using USB or Thunderbolt. Also note that Thunderbolt play or USB play 1 and 2 are your main stereo output channels from your computer, for example like you would use for a media player. The ADAT and S Pdif inputs represent the physical inputs on the Orion Studio. The AFX out represents the outputs from the software effects processors on the effects tab, so if you route a source to the effects, the signal will be output here. Lastly, we have the four software mixer stereo outputs. In the two section, we have 16 line outs that represent the physical line outs of the D-Sub25 connectors on the rear panel of the Orion Studio. The level of all these outputs can be controlled by a slider on the settings tab. Then we have the two headphone outputs, each with channels 1 left and 2 right. The monitor outs will feed whatever you route to your monitor speakers, for example Thunderbolt Play 1 and 2. The two reamp outs represent the outputs on the front panel of the unit. You can use them to send a signal from your DAW, for example USB Play 5 and 6, to your amplifier for reamping. Notice also that the volume level of the reamp outs can be controlled from the front panel of the device by pressing the rotary control and adjusting the reamp volume. The Thunderbolt Rec 32 channels and USB Rec 24 channels represent the inputs in your DAW. Whatever you route to these channels will be sent to your DAW inputs for recording. For example, preamp channels 1 to 12 will be input channels 1 to 12 in your DAW. The ADAT and S Pdif outputs represent the physical outputs for each protocol. The AFX ins are the inputs for each one of the 16 channels of the software effects processors. And finally, we have the four software mixer inputs, each one of them with 32 channels. The routing matrix also features an undo and redo function to help you to route. The save and load function help you to store and recall your custom made presets. By left clicking on a channel in the from section, you can rename it. And by right clicking on a channel on the to section, you can mute or assign one of the oscillators to it. To route, simply drag and drop channels from the from section to the to section. To To select multiple tracks, simply hold the Shift key while left-clicking a selection. Note that the channels on the To section will receive the color and the name, if renamed, from the From section, enabling you to easily see which channels are routed to where. On the Mixer tab, you can control the four mixers independently. Each mixer has 32 channels with the following controls: Aura Verb Send control, Pan, Fader, Solo, Mute and Stereo Link, and on the far right is the Master Fader with a mute button. Antelope Aura Verb is only available on Mix 1. The Aura Verb also features 24 presets made by multiple Grammy Award winning producer Brian Vibbets, as well as save and load options. The Effects tab has 16 individual EQs and compressors. Both processors feature the standard controls plus save, load and bypass options. You can also change the order of the EQ and compressor by clicking on the flip switch. And you can stereo link two channels by clicking here. The meters accurately display whatever you select on the drop-down menu. The five presets enable you to save your favorite custom-made setups. The Settings tab contains the trim levels for the monitor and line outs, and two oscillators can be individually assigned to any of the outputs by right-clicking on them on the routing matrix. The Pdif sample rate converter converts any sample rate of an incoming Pdif signal to the Orion Studio's current sample rate. The Talkback options allow you to assign the Talkback function to each of the headphone outs and the monitor outs. The Line Out Volume slider and Mute button adjusts the level of all the line outputs from the D-Sub25 connectors. A Brightness slider adjusts the front panel screen on the device itself. At the bottom of the Settings tab, you can also find the buffer size and streaming mode settings for Windows computers. The Info tab informs you about current versions of the control panel and firmware, your hardware revision, and the serial number of your unit, so you can read it without unracking your device. The Firmware Update button takes you to the firmware update process. Now you can easily get to work with your Orion Studio device.